Buick is a company that's known for primarily two things. Back in the day, they used to build some pretty sweet muscle cars and powerful boulevard cruisers. Then they transitioned into a company that was more known for building vehicles designed to appeal to older folk. They're trying to get away from that, even though they're not ignoring that end of the spectrum. They want to appeal to a wider audience, and they're doing that with vehicles like the Encore and the Verano. One vehicle, though, that perhaps younger millennial families should think about looking at is the Enclave, because it's a three-row SUV that could be just what you're looking for. Styling-wise, the Enclave is a bit of a mixed bag. There's Buick elements that you'd expect, like this grille up here in the large Buick bag. The portholes, which should be on the fender, have been moved to the hood. Coming around to the side, these are nicely designed wheels, and we like seeing big, meaty tires, because this is a world where everything is thinner sidewalls, but it's good to see some actual sidewall. However, I'm not in love with the chrome. That's a take it or leave it option. Coming down to the side, it's a big canvas. They could do a lot with it, but they keep it subtle, and that's probably what the Buick audience likes. There is little flourishes here and there. There's a little bit more chrome as well. Coming around to the back, it's fairly plain. So if you want subtle styling, it's good to go, but if you want a little bit more outrageous looks, you're gonna have to look elsewhere. Under the hood, we've got a 3.6 liter V6 engine. Makes 288 horsepower and 270 pound-feet of torque, and it's paired with a 6-speed automatic gearbox. And additionally, you can select to have front-wheel drive or all-wheel drive. Obviously, all-wheel drive is going to give you a hit in terms of fuel economy, but you're still going to get over 20 miles per gallon on the highway with both choices. With the front-wheel drive, you're actually closer to 24 miles per gallon, which is decent for a vehicle this size. So you've got a strong motor, you know, 200, near 300 horsepower. It's plenty for a vehicle like this. It pulls. It's not a rocket ship, but it gets the job done. If the outside of the Enclave is a little dull, the interior is actually where it starts to shine a little bit. As I said, this is a three-row vehicle, and that back row can actually fit adults, believe it or not. That's a rarity these days, but there you go. You can fit back there. I can fit back there, which means you can fit back there. In the second row, they've added a USB outlet for the middle row seats, which is nice to have. I wish more vehicles would start doing that, just putting USB outlets everywhere. Up front, though, in the driver's seat, this is a nice space. It's well designed, it's well laid out, it looks handsome, it looks premium. Soft, comfortable leather seats, a really nice center stack here that is just clean, simple, easy to read with a great display. It looks and feels as much as it should by the way of the price point, because this starts at about $38,000, but you're easily into the $40,000 range once you start adding the most basic of options on this vehicle. And that's how much it should cost. That's how much a premium three-row SUV crossover costs, so there's nothing strange there. With a vehicle this size, you might be inclined to think that 288 horsepower isn't gonna get the job done. We live in a world where everything is 300 horsepower and up, but you'd be wrong. There's plenty of power here. If you push the gas hard enough, this thing picks up and gets going. It's not fast, but it's plenty quick and it gets out of its own way. On top of that, the steering is actually really properly weighted. I expected it to be on the lighter side just because the demographic that's gonna buy this car probably doesn't wanna work too hard with the steering wheel, but it feels nice. It's much better than I expected. Additionally, the brakes are progressive and they feel good. They haul in any speed you generate with the Enclave nicely. And that's important with a vehicle of this size so that you are confident and it keeps everybody back there nice and happy. One thing we find a bit odd considering this segment is that there's an actual key. You have to put it in, turn it, and start the vehicle, which isn't crazy, but at this price point, you'd expect a proximity key and a push button start system. And we're a little surprised that the Enclave doesn't have that. Some folks out there look for reasons to buy American vehicles, and that's fine. I don't have a problem with that. I think if you just limit yourself to that, you're missing out on some great choices out there. The Volvo XC90, wonderful offering. The Mercedes R-Class, thinking a little bit differently outside the box, is actually one of my favorite vehicles. But the Buick has plenty to offer and competes with them, absolutely. It has more cargo room, in fact. It's got great options like heated and cooled seats, this wonderful screen, and plenty of room for cargo and people. So it is a good choice, it's well priced, it gets over 20 miles per gallon on the highway, and it's got a competent V6 engine. If you're in the market for a three-row, full-size crossover, and you want something that's a little bit luxurious, but you don't want to go all the way up to Escalade levels of size and money, maybe you should check out the 2014 Buick Enclave.